sake, Michael, not this shit again. I'm sick to death of hearing about Conor
McGregor. But you won't listen, Kathleen.
Michael, what he did was so out of order. He tried to threaten people with a chair.
He didn't, Kathleen. He came out of the stadium, Kathleen, and he looked into the bus, and he seen an old man, Kathleen, that didn't have a seat, and he was trying to hand him a chair, Kathleen.
Michael, no.
That's the type of hero he is.
Michael, he flung a trolley through a bus window.
He didn't, Kathleen.
And injured people.
He seen the tyre was going low, Kathleen.
What?
And he was there thinking to himself, oh, that bus looks very unsafe and unsatisfactory, Kathleen. I better go and warn the people. And he was trying to jack it up, Kathleen, to change the tyres on.
Michael, not only is that bizarre, but McGregor does not have an American accent. And also, what was with all the extreme swearing and shouting?
He was warning the people, Kathleen.
Warning who?
He was saying, come out of there. Come off that bus. That's not safe. And the window wasn't broken, Kathleen. Well, it was, but it was broken for good reason, Kathleen. There was a bald man smoking nicotinettes.
What?
Kathleen, fags at the back of the bus. And he broke the window, Kathleen, to let air in.
Michael.
He's a hero, Kathleen.
I literally saw him legging it afterwards in fear.
He didn't, Kathleen. He got lost. His GPS wasn't working. As soon as he knew the Inmabidi were after him, Kathleen, didn't he sign himself into the Garda station?
Michael, I don't get it. No matter how terrible or awful someone acts, you always just somehow manage to see the best in them, and it's ridiculous.
I don't for Ulster rugby players!
Jesus.